I see the transformation in our people operating system, and this is something I've been watching for years. So now we're just seeing that they use Trump. They use Trump and they pose themselves as the resistance. So they use the language, the elites use the language of egalitarian, and they've used all this language to kind of roll up power. And so when you say, how does the average person fight for the Republic? I think there's a few things going on. I think that's first a question of defining the Republic within what it was and now what it's going to be. Right. So I think one of the difficulties that people are having now is we see the transformation in our people operating system, but we're seeing so many intra-America squabbles that people don't have the opportunity to mediate what the Republic will look like going forward. If there is a Republic, the intra-America squabbles are distracting people from being able to mediate a surrender to the elites. So we're not able to get to a compromise. One of them would, for example, being how much AI can be utilized and how it can be utilized, how much robotics can be utilized, passing real rigid laws about it. So now let me go backwards to another part of your question. So when you're saying a republic, are you referring to kind of the rules that dictated, how people got along, how business is operated. So because I think a lot of people are used to a system where we're seeing so much chaos right now, which is deliberate, because when there's chaos, there's only the government can be the arbiter of it. So perhaps what you're then asking is not the Republic the way it was, because I don't think that that's reconcilable. I think it's gone irrevocably. I think the death knell was when the conservatives collectively became lockdown COVID people without any type of interlocutory, without any type of prosecution or questions. I think they